Everybody, Mike here. Today I'm going to show you how to get started using GoGuardian Teacher. First, you're going to go to teacher.goguardian.com and you're going to see a screen that looks like this. You'll click Login with Google. If it asks, you'll utilize your Edina Google account. When it comes in, you come to a dashboard that looks like so. And right now I already have a class that I was playing around with that is on here, but in my pending section, so you'll go to pending and you'll see that all of the sections that you teach this semester or school year are going to show up here. And what you need to do is accept these sections in order for them to come into your active classes. So I'm going to go ahead and accept the classes that I'm assigned to. And then when we go to active, now I have all these classes that show up. So that's step one. Prior to actually using GoGuardian class or teacher with your students, you want to set up some scenes or groups of websites that you want to apply to the class before you get started. So to do that, we're going to click on the Scenes menu over here, and it gives you the option of creating an allowed website list of these are the ones that students are only allowed to access these sites. And then there's one called the blocked websites list where you can create a list that they can get to any website except the ones that you've listed. Now, I've already created some, one called Assessment Time and one called No GChat, one called Turn Off Common Distractions like GChat, YouTube, and Unblocked Game Sites. To access those, you can actually go into Create a List, and you start off, you have to give the list a name. So let's say you wanted to use one for summative assessments. You could call it that. And then when you click Next, it's going to ask you to start typing in all the websites you want to have. Well, we've created some quick lists for you. So if you click on quick lists, one of the ones that we've created is this summative assessment one, and it will grab all 12 of the websites that you may need on a summative assessment and put that in. Or maybe you want to focus on digital citizenship. You could select those two and not that one. But in this case, you can select this one, and any assessment that you give in Schoology that includes possibly Turnitin, Edpuzzle, Schoology assessment, or others will automatically be selected, and those are the only ones that they can go to. This list is also set up, and I'll show you in a second. So we say we're going to use this summative assessment list, and at the bottom, we have to say add to scene, sorry. And now it shows the list of things. But the other thing that you'll want to do is set a tab limit for students. So realize they'll probably need to get to the portal. They may need to get to Schoology, and they may need one other tab depending. So you might limit it to 3. And once you've got that, you can hit save. And then that's going to add that allowed website list to your list. So that's one way of doing it. You can also, on scenes, do the blocked list. So let's say there's a site that you definitely don't want them to go to. You can create that list, type it in, Google, whatever it happens to be. And then you can actually type in, search for google.com, say add it, and now google.com has been added to it. You can also put an asterisk there, and that's what's known as a wildcard. And by putting a wildcard in, and you can do this on both sides of the address, anything that comes before Google or anything that comes after google.com would be blocked. So you can add, sometimes adding those wildcards gets to allows a little more broader number of sites to be blocked for sure. So that's something that you can do. Or again, with the quick lists, you can go in and look and say, okay, I don't want YouTube, or I want to make sure it's just limited to certain things. So you can set those lists up ahead of time and then set the number of tabs available and save that, and they'll show up for you over here on your scenes, like so. And you can always edit them, you can rename them, you can copy them if you want to add more to it for other activities and things. You have those options. So now that you've created your scenes and you have your classes in the system, it's time to try starting a session. So I'm going to go down here to this test session and I'm going to say I'm going to start a class. And when it comes on, there's no restrictions set on the students, but I can see any student that's live in my class. I can expand their stuff to see what they're looking at on the screen. I can see they have some different tabs open here, and this looks pretty typical of what a student should be on. And you'll see all of the students in your class, something similar. You've got a grid here to kind of change the size of that so you can see more kids per row, etc. You can select students. You can, by selecting students, you can lock their device. So if you wanted to select none or select all students, you could click if they're online, and then you could say lock their device, for example. Or you could open a new tab and take them to a new site. You can do screenshots or see screenshots that have been taken. You can exclude them from the session. So let's say they're working independently and doing just fine. I can exclude Marvin from the session if that's the case. We're not going to utilize the call or chat options within here right now, but you do have the option to have that. Right now, we're going to leave the chat off. You do have the ability to get off-task alerts, but I recommend that for right now, you leave that off for now. But then once the session is on, you can apply a scene. And so you can either create a new scene, or you can use that assessment scene, let's say, or you can say, let's turn off the common distraction ones. So if we turn off the common distraction ones, that scene's been applied, and now Marvin has that scene on there. And what that means is that with this common distractions one, that Marvin couldn't go to GChat and shouldn't be able to go to YouTube. When you're ready to end it, you can end it and say end the session, and it comes back. By creating and ending a session, you're going to end up seeing a you're going to get an email with information about that session. You can also go to timelines and see what students were looking at while you were in that session and things like that. Now, let's say I wanted to start another session again. Again, I'm going to do the common distractions one and start that. So now it's back on. And let's say I wanted to see what Marvin sees. So if I pull up Marvin here, now Marvin has that session applied. So if I come to OmniID portal and I go to Google Drive, Marvin does have access to Google Drive. But if Marvin tries to go to YouTube, Marvin's going to get a message that says, hey, you reached a site your teacher doesn't want you to browse right now. If it's a mistake, let the teacher know, etc. Now you can also, let's say Marvin says, okay, well, what about going to Google and Unblock games, because there's lots of unblock games that I could get to. And here's one. That site's been blocked. So that shows that our filter is blocking that particular site. But if I even go to sites, they show me that that isn't available right now because a lot of unblocked games show up on the sites in Google, and so that distraction one keeps you from that. Again, two, chat is turned off on this one, so I'm also getting the block as Marvin in that case. As you begin using GoGuardian Teacher, one of the things you'll have to remember as you get into teaching is that sometimes it's important to remember to end the session. I've had that experience where I got doing something or I wanted to get something else going and I forgot that that session was still running. So that's why we're recommending not necessarily using the set times that are built in or having it set to go to follow your schedule and automatically come on, because there may be days when your schedule is changed and you don't want to use it. So use it prescriptively. Click on the class, maybe say how long do you want it to go? Maybe 30 minutes, maybe it's a custom end time. I just want to go for a certain amount of time and have that scene on there. You also may find that there are times when you're doing this where you'll have kids that are working on something, and one student may be done with their work. And so then, do you want to end the scene for them so that they can go on and do work in other classes while the others may have the scene applied because you want them to continue to have some focus and working on what you want to do in your subject area? So that's something you're going to want to be thinking about. We're also going to have requests that you kind of do a reflection after a couple weeks. We'll send out a reflection every so often to say, how's it going? What have you found? How has it impacted your teaching? How has it impacted your interaction with kids? Are you working going around the room more? Are you finding yourself back behind your computer screen? Things like that to kind of reflect on how this is being used and what successes you're having or things that aren't working, so that we can try and troubleshoot those. So look forward to seeing how this works as you move through the year, and we'll be here to support you as you start implementing it. We appreciate your patience as you've waited for us to kind of get our ducks in a row for setting this up and rolling it out to you. But with that, we wish you the best of luck as you try piloting this, and feel free to reach out with any questions that you have. Thanks, and have a great day.